Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is DeLady Designer. We are back with another speed build video of Meilin Zoo. Please do make sure to subscribe, of course, if you already haven't, and leave a like at the video if you guys enjoy. And in this video, we are going to build a House of Primates. So, as we wanted to do in the previous episode, but we ended up with the ring-tailed lemur, I really want to add the gorilla and the chimpanzees in this House of Primates. So we're going to start today with the gorillas, and the next episode will be for the chimpanzees, and then we're going to finish off this whole building. But so far it's starting to look really nice, and I think it's fun to have like this main road going through it, and there will be a different separate smaller road from the area from the lemurs. You probably will see that path section a little bit, but we're going to use that to go probably over the chimpanzees' habitat or anything like that. And since we've learned from the beta where we built the dome and then the mandrills' habitat, we didn't want to have any bottlenecks for the main road, so that's why we have a separate viewing gallery from that side to look into the outside habitat of the gorillas, because else it will be too busy. And we have a very big, wide, open road going through this building, which obviously doesn't look like a road, but just people going through the building. But I think it looks really nice. I'm really happy with it. We're not finished yet. We still have to do a little bit of detailing, but I think we're getting there. And the idea of this building is to create half of the building and then just duplicate the whole thing to the other side, so we basically will have two different viewing areas inside of this primate's house. And we obviously have to live a little bit with the amount of space. The gorillas do have enough space, so it's all good. But also regarding like climbing structures and stuff, because if you make it too narrow and too busy, your staff will not be able to fill feeders, for example. So you really have to keep that in mind, and that's why I can't really do too much crazy things. But as far as I remember from real life gorilla habitats, they don't have like super dense climbing structures and stuff, so I ended up with like more of very big logs and stuff, and they are absolutely happy with the amount of climbing stuff in their habitat right now. And on the inside of the habitat, I wanted to make sure that you have like some kind of platform. Like, I do remember a lot from going to real life zoos that you have like gorillas laying down to the glass area, or like really close, and the people would be really up close to them. Now, we had like this incident a few years ago in Rotterdam Zoo. It's already a long time ago, but that was Boquito, and like a lady always went to Boquito and she always looked him in the eyes. And at some point, I don't remember exactly how it went, but he was able to break out and he got that woman and he ran around with her through the zoo, and it was really terrible. So yeah, back then he still had the ability to be really close to the glass, and they changed it after that incident. So there's no way of Boquito getting out of the habitat, obviously. And also, like, you can't be really up close to them anymore, even though there's glass in between. I don't think they have real one-sided glass, because else he would not have seen her looking her in the eyes, right? So I don't know how that really works, but for this zoo, we decided to have the people can go to the glass, and we do have one-sided glass, so that's a little bit different. Like, I keep mentioning I don't really go for the super realistic look, but we're also not doing a fairy tale zoo or anything like that. So I want to have fun. I want to have sometimes some realistic details, but I'm not going too much into realism, because I just don't really want to go that far. I just want to have fun. I think that's the most important thing for me. And I just want it to look good, I guess. So on the outside of the viewing platform, that is something that is a little bit more of the realism, because I just really felt the difference between the height of the path and the terrain was like super low, so it didn't really felt try to have it super low without anything in between. So I ended up with like some wooden walls and some glass in the end. You will see that definitely in the end, me building that during the speed build and also in the cinematic shots, of course. Now, what I did forget to do is to uncheck the box for the sandbox mode that animals are able to get babies, because I turned off aging and stuff, but then you also turn off the birth. I wish that was like a separate option, because I don't want my animals to grow up, but I do want my animals to get babies, and I don't know if there is an option to have one of each, but for now it's not really possible. So yeah, that's a pity. So yeah, we don't have any babies, but since that starts to work now and we don't have any issues, I will definitely make sure when the map will be on Steam uploaded, when it's finished, I will have some babies in there too, so don't worry about that. But I can't really show them at this stage because I just don't have any babies. But maybe if we have the next episode with the chimpanzees, I can definitely try to get some babies in, because I just really like that, and it's so much fun to see the difference of, like, you have the big gorillas and then the female, and they are like so different already in size, and it's just nice to see like the babies next to it, so you have the different size variations in it. I must say that I did not really use too much inspiration for this build. In fact, I didn't really look up anything. I just tried to, as I mentioned before, I just started building something and just waited to see where I end up with it. So yeah, I'm actually really happy with how it turned out, and I think especially with the outside area, having it a little bit divided, and we're gonna have an outside and an inside area too for the chimpanzee, so we're gonna do a little bit of the same thing, but then we have a path going over the habitat or anything like that. I'm super curious how that will end up, because I have no idea yet, but hopefully you guys will enjoy it and have some inspiration out of it. And it's also quite nice that when the people are standing on the outside viewing platform for the gorillas, that you can still look a little bit into the Indian elephant habitat, so that is really nice, and you still have like the nice view of the dome. So I really like how this whole park is getting together, and you have different viewing points and stuff. Oh, also good to mention, by the way, that I wasn't really able to lower the terrain on the outside of the gorillas, because I have like a path system for the staff going underneath it. So if I would go too low and the terrain would be too thin, then the gorillas probably will clip through the terrain, or you get like weird warnings, or they get boxed or anything like that. And that's also the reason why I couldn't put down the doors of the habitat for the staff on the side of where I wanted it to be, because that's path section for the staff is underneath it. So I just had to really try and see what would work for me, and in the end I just ended up with like a path above it and just connect it to the main road. And yeah, well, it is what it is. You sometimes just don't want to put too much time into the path system, because it's just so wonky, and just live with it, I guess, and just build around what you can do, instead of like, no, I really want to have my path like this or that. I just, well, with like the 3,000 hours I had in Planet Coaster and having the same path system in Planet Zoo, you just really have to live with how you get the path sometimes and work around that, instead of like really trying to create what you want it to do, what you want the path to do. So yeah, because it's gonna take you like so many hours of just getting that path right. So I just really got used to it, like, okay, I just have to live with the path system like it is right now. But it's really unfortunate that they didn't change the path system with Planet Zoo, but you get used to it, I guess. But just know that even people that have played so many hours of Planet Coaster, so sometimes can get really frustrated about the path system, but yeah, it is what it is. I do still am really happy with the terrain forming and the shapes. It's so useful, and it's so nice to get an easy way of hiring or lower the terrain, so I really like that. So I do have to say that I really love that terrain tool, but yeah, the path system is just so wonky, it's so sad. So yeah, if you need any help with how I raise this path, for example, for the viewing gallery, I often still get questions about that. I've made some tutorials, so if you need any help with ideas for like viewing galleries or like those raised viewing platforms you've got, or like building tips of how you can use the 3D gizmo and stuff, or build a dome, please do go and check out my tutorials, because they might be very useful if you're pretty new to the Planet franchise and you haven't played Planet Coaster. I would highly recommend you to watch those. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it for now. I really want to thank you guys so much for watching. Please do make sure to subscribe, of course, if you already haven't, and leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed. And I really hope to see you guys in the next one, where we will be creating the habitat for the chimpanzees. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope to see you in the next one. Bye, guys.